I'm Joanna Simpson here at QuantMinds International in London. Joining me now is Youssef Elouerkhaoui, Managing Director and Global Head of Markets Quantitative Analysis at Citi. Thank you very much for joining me today.
Thank you for having me.
And what are the latest innovations in deep pricing? And what challenges were you able to overcome with new methodologies?
Well, thank you for the question. This is what we just spoke about in the presentation just half an hour ago. I've been talking about deep pricing for a while now, for a couple of years, and you know, we've evolved the methods, you know, from just using a standard neural network, you know, to do kind of regression type pricing in high dimensional spaces. And then kind of last year, we moved from that, you know, to having a much more constrained network with subwavelength training, so adding derivatives, you know, to the function, adding shape to the function, which is a bit better. Kind of this year, you know, really inspired by the Gen AI or generative machine learning type of methods, you know, we're moving away from doing a regression problem to a probabilistic framework. Yeah, so instead of looking at the points X and Y that we want to regress on, and just a simple functional form, you know, we look at it as a probability distribution. Yeah? Now with the Gen AI or generative machine learning methods, you know, we have ways of producing probability distributions, you know, that fit, you know, a sample of data points basically, and those are used generically for image generation, right? You have pictures of cats and dogs, and you use a VAE or a GAN, you know, to simulate, you know, similar pictures. You know, we use similar techniques in this context basically, but, you know, for regression problems, yeah? But because, you know, we have a much more constrained, you know, problem, right? So we generate a distribution, and then the actual fitting of a function becomes a conditional expectation. No, we have all grown up in probability theory, you know, so that's what we're doing here, leveraging that knowledge. So computing the actual regression function as an expectation of Y conditional on X, you know, does a much better job at fitting the function. It's much more stable than a standard kind of regression.
And with new AI and machine learning tools such as large language models becoming widely available, are you inspired by them? And how might they impact your work?
Absolutely. So that's, again, the progression. You know, the usage of Gen AI now has been, completely, fully motivated, you know, recently with the large language models, right? You know, we had Gen AI for some time, you know, with VAEs and GANs and other methods, you know, like that. But, you know, having these transformers, you know, that were used specifically, you know, for large language models, you know, have made those methods, you know, very, very popular, right? And that's, in part, you know, the reason why I was inspired, right, you know, to kind of look at these Gen AI or generative machine learning methods in the context of problems that kind of I care about, which is kind of regression pricing problems. You know, and I think that trend of using generative methods, you know, is going to continue, right? Because, you know, those are very rich in structure, but also now, you know, they can be used, you know, in practice, some very, very relevant problems.
And there are a lot of economic factors influencing financial institutions right now. How resilient do you think deep pricing methods are to market shocks?
Yeah. So it's very, very simple. You have the two classes of models. So standard regression models and probabilistic methods. With the regression models, actually, you know, they tend, you know, to do very well in the middle, but the extrapolation, you know, tends, you know, to be weaker, you know, in the extremities of your domain, right? You know, again, the problem we have high maturities, low spreads and so on, low strikes and so on. So the boundaries of the problem, you know, it struggles with extrapolation, yeah? So that's what happens with regression. With probabilistic methods, because you are imposing a structure on the model with a latent space underneath it, you have high dimensional space, you have a latent representation, that so you're projecting your space on this kind of smaller latent space, basically, and you do an operation on the latent space, you know, that problem becomes much more tractable and much more efficient, right? And because of that, you know, those problems that you tend, you know, to have in the boundaries of your domain, with extrapolation, don't happen, you know, in these probabilistic methods, right?
Youssef Elouerkhaoui, thank you very much for your time today.
Thank you for having me. Thank you.